Let us talk about this problem. We are given an array. We need to find out second largest element in it. We need to return index of the second largest element. Let's understand the problem with these examples. We have this array 10, 5, 8, 20. Largest element is 20. Second largest is 10. Index of 10 is 0. That's why our output is 0. In this example, the largest element is 20. There are two occurrences of 20. So we don't consider the other occurrence as the second largest element. We consider both of them as largest. And the second largest element is 12. So the output is index of 12, which is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's see this example. This is an interesting corner case. All the elements in this array are same. So we have every element as a largest element and there is no second largest element. In this case, we need to return the index as minus 1, which is not a valid index, to indicate that there is no second largest element in this array. Now please pause this video and try to write down a function that takes an array as an argument and returns the index of the second largest element. Let us first talk about a naive solution to solve the problem. Please note that it's not very naive also. It's linear time complexity solution. It is just that this solution does two traversals of the array, and later we are going to talk about the solution which finds the second largest in one traversal. The idea here is simple. We first find the index of the largest element, then we find largest among the remaining elements. We compare only those elements which are not equal to the largest element and find the largest among them. And that's how we find the second largest. So if you see this example, 5, 20, 12, 20, 10, we'll first find the largest element, right? You can notice that we have a function getLargest and we are calling it in the second largest as the first thing, right? So the first thing we do in the second largest function is we find the index of largest element and index of largest, because largest might appear multiple times. Like here it appears two times. So this getLargest function works very simple way. It initializes the largest element as 0, right? 0 is index of the largest element. Then it begins from the second element. For every element, if it compares with the current largest, and if current element is greater than current largest, then updates the largest. So when it comes to here, right, your current largest must be 0. It comes here and sees that this element is greater than current largest, so it updates current largest to 1. Now it comes here and it sees that it's not greater than current largest, so it does not update the current largest, simply ignores this element 12. It comes to 20 and it's also not greater than current largest, so ignores this element. It comes to 10. This is also not greater than current largest, so it ignores 10 also. So the largest value or index of the largest value returned by this getLargest function is 1. This function returns index of the largest value as 1. Now we have the largest element. How do we find the second largest element using this largest index? We again traverse the array and we only focus on the elements which are not equal to the largest element, right? And please note that second largest element function can return minus 1, because there can be an array like 10, 10, 10 we discussed earlier where there is no second largest element. So in those cases, we return minus 1. That is why we initialize the result as minus 1, not as 0 like we did in largest, right? Because there might not exist any second largest element. We initialize the result as minus 1, then we traverse through all the elements and we consider only those elements which are not equal to largest, right? We go inside this if condition only if the current element is not equal to the largest. And for every element, what we do is we check if the result is set as minus 1, then this is first element which is not equal to largest. So we mark this as the result itself. For example, after finding the largest as 1, I'll traverse the array from here and I'll have the result as minus 1 initially. When I come to this element, this is not equal to array largest, so I'll update the result as 0. Right? Now I'll go to this element and this is equal to the largest, so I'll ignore it, right? I'll not do anything if it is equal to largest. Now I'll come to 12 and I'll go inside this if condition. I'll see that result is not minus 1. Result is already set by some value. Now I'll compare this element with the array result. And if this element is greater than array result, then I'll update the result as this element. So when I come to 12, I'll update the result as 2. Right? Index of 12. Now I'll come to 20. And when I come to 20, I'll not go inside this if condition. Right? I simply ignore all the largest elements. So 20 is ignored. Now I come to 10. I come inside this if condition. I notice that result is not minus 1, but this 10 is not greater than 12. Error result is 12. So we do not update the result. So our finally result remains 2, which is correct result, which is index of element 12. So this is how we get the second largest element. Now, talking about this implementation, I have written an implementation here which is close to both C++ and Java. If you are programming in Java, then you don't need to pass this n. You can get the n as arr.length. Otherwise, this code is same for both C++ and Java, right? You don't need to pass this n in Java. Again, here also, you don't need to pass n. You can get the n by using arr.length, because in Java, arrays are objects. Otherwise, rest of the things are exactly same in both C++ and Java, the same implementation. Let us now take one more example to understand this naive approach better. Let's say we have the array elements as 10, 10, 10. We'll get the largest as index of the first 10. We'll get the largest as 0. Now we'll run this loop, right? And we'll never go inside this if condition. Our result will remain minus 1. So when we come out of the rule, come out of the loop, we'll return result as minus 1, which is the answer for this example. Now please pause this video and think of an approach that finds the second largest using one traversal of the array. Here we are doing two traversals. We are traversing once to find the get largest and then one more traversal. You need to find the second largest using one traversal. Let us now talk about the efficient solution. The idea of this efficient solution is, if you consider your array as a stream of data, and if you traverse this stream from left to right, you can always keep track of largest and second largest till this point. Let's see how. Say we have this stream of data, right? And we are traversing this stream from A0 and we have traversed till AI-1 and we have computed largest and second largest for this array from 0 to I-1. Now element AI comes in. So we should be able to decide largest and second largest till this point in constant time. Then only we can say that this is one traversal solution and finds the largest and second largest in linear time. Let's see what are the cases that arise when you consider the next element in the stream. So the first case is the next element that you are considering, it's the greater than the largest so far. Suppose you already had seen elements 5, 8, 12. And now you see an element 20. So you already had computed largest and second largest here. Now if this 20 is greater than this, then what you will do? You will make this element as largest and you will make the earlier largest as your second largest. So before you saw 20, this must have been your largest and this must have been your result, second largest. So what you do now is you make this result as largest. Result now becomes 12 and largest now becomes 20. So we handle this case this way, and this is perfectly fine because this earlier largest now becomes the second largest and the new largest becomes the largest, right? Now the second case, when array I is equal to the largest, suppose you had elements like these and you now saw it 12. What will you do in this case? You will simply ignore this 12, because when a new element comes in which is equal to your existing largest, it's not going to change anything. It's not going to change the second largest, it's not going to change the largest. So you simply ignore this 12. And this is the most complicated case, when array I is the new element that you are seeing, AI is smaller than largest. Suppose the element that you are adding now is 7, right? Now there are three cases arise when you add a new element. The first case is you had never seen a second largest element before. Suppose your array was like this, 12, 12, 12. Result must have been set as minus 1, right? And now you saw a 7. What do you do in this case? In this case, you simply mark this as a result because this is a new element. All the elements were same so far and they were all largest, right? Now the second case is there was a second largest element. Suppose this was your second largest element. But the new element that you are seeing is smaller than or equal to the existing second largest element. In that case also, you will ignore this element, right? Because it's not going to update the second largest. Second largest is going to remain as 8. Even if it was 7, even if it was equal, it's going to remain as 7, right? It's not going to update the result. Now the next case, suppose there were these elements so far. Now you saw 9. This is the case when your AI is greater than A result. What do you do in this case? So your AI is smaller than largest and greater than result. In this case, you update the result as I. So we can handle all the cases for a new upcoming element, and we can accommodate this upcoming element in our existing stream in big O of one time by doing these comparisons. And that's what we have implemented here in this code. That's the implementation of the idea. We initialize result as -1, we initialize largest as 0, we start from the second largest element, and if this new element is greater than the largest, then we are in this case, we update the result as largest and we update the largest as I, right? Now, this else if part handles these cases, right? When it's equal, we simply ignore, right? So we don't have any else part, right? So we simply ignore the equal elements. Now we go inside this only when this is not equal. So we are here now. In this case, if result is -1, then we update the result as I. Or if AI is greater than array result, then also we update the result as I. So you can notice an OR operator. If result is I or AI is greater than A result, then we update our result as I. Otherwise, we ignore it. If it is more than equal to A result, then we ignore it. Let us now quickly see a dry run of this code for this example, 5, 20, 12, 28. We initialize the largest as 0. We initialize the result as -1. Now we run a loop for I equal to 1. And what we do inside this, we check if it is greater than largest. So this is greater than largest. So we update the result as 0 and we update the largest as 1. Now we come to the next element, 12. This is not greater than largest, so we come into the else if part, and it's not equal to largest also, largest is 20. Now we check if result is -1 or AI is greater than result. So AI is greater than result, right? Result is for 5, index 0, and AI is 12. So it's greater than A result, so we update our result as 2. Now we come to the element 20, it's equal to the largest, so we ignore it. Now we come to the element 8, so we ignore it, right? We come inside, but we don't fall in this if condition. So we ignore it because it's smaller than the second largest that you have seen so far. So this is one traversal solution. Talking about the time complexity of the solution, this is clearly theta n solution, and auxiliary space requirement is theta 1, and this finds the second largest in one traversal only.